We now have all of the pieces of the program necessary to make a Simon game. It's just a matter of putting them together. So to do that, I'm going to scroll to the bottom of my setup, and I'm going to create a new variable. This one is just going to be a Boolean, a true or a false, and I'm going to call it keep playing. And I'm going to set this one equal to true. I'm going to use this variable to control a while loop. So I'm going to say while keep playing. Now, since it starts out true, this is going to resolve to true, and we're going to go through the while loop until keep playing comes to resolves to false. The commands inside my while loop are going to be the very first one is we're going to add to our sequence. Our sequence starts out blank. There's nothing in it right up here. So the very first thing we do is we add a random color to our sequence. Then we're going to show the sequence to the player. Once we show the sequence to the player, we're going to see if they were correctly able to match the sequence. And we're going to actually set the keep playing variable equal to the result of the match sequence function. Remember, this returns false if the player was unsuccessful, and it returns a true if the player was successful. So we're going to keep playing based on whether or not the player is able to match the sequence. And then just to make it so that there's a little bit of space or a little bit of a delay in between the player pressing the last, the button that corresponds to the last item in the sequence, and the player seeing the first item in the sequence when it's displayed again, I'm going to put a little delay right here. Just a half second delay. You can make it longer or shorter depending on what suits you. Once you've added all of these items to your while loop, outside your while loop, but before the end of your setup, let's type serial.println, and I want to print game over. So we'll at least be able to see in the serial monitor that the game is over. With this code, we should now be able to play our Simon game. I'm going to open the serial monitor just co so I can see whether game over appears if I make a mistake. My game appears to be functioning like it's supposed to. If I press the buttons that correspond to the correct colors, as you can see them down here, then it keeps adding another random color to the sequence. Now I'm going to make a mistake. I'll go ahead and press red and then green. And if I do that, it tells me that the game is over. I did it incorrectly. So, if you reach this point, congratulations, you've done it. You've correctly coded all of the basic functionality of a Simon game. Once you've tested your code and you've made sure that it's working, make a commit to Bitbucket. I really encourage you to go beyond what I've shown you here and make this game your own. Add extensions that interest you, that work the way you want them to. You're going to learn far more about programming and circuits when you try to do something that I haven't shown you. It's going to be a great way to review what you've already learned and to learn new things as well.